What's going on, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of multiple generation and next? It is another video. It's been a minute. I know. I'm sorry. But it has been exactly 10 years, I guess, as of this recording. You'll get it probably the next day or the day after that, whenever I decide. Anyway, it's been 10 years since the infamous pipe bomb delivered by CM Punk on WWE Raw. And I know a lot of people are probably tired of hearing this and seeing this promo uploaded every single week on Twitter or Instagram or Facebook. I know. I feel you. I'm needed to go away sometime. But it has been 10 years since we've seen this pipe bomb that brought a lot of fans back to the wrestling industry. Now, I know modern wrestling nowadays is kind of missing something, or it's just a lot of people are pretty much tuning out again for whatever reason. But we're going to reminisce on today's video, and hopefully you guys enjoy it just like I do, because I'm personally a fan of CM Punk. I was always a fan of CM Punk, and I'm one of the people who believe that he should have been at least in one WrestleMania main event. I mean, come on. That's the past, and we're going to relive the past, and we're going to just reminisce in what was an epic, I guess you could say, scripted shoot, rant, whatever the case may be. It was good. It brought my attention back. It brought a lot of people's attention back. So if you're new to the channel, make sure you smash that like button, comment your thoughts, subscribe if you haven't already subscribed, and let's get right to the video. YouTube, WWE, please don't copyright this.
Moving slowly, hit those steel steps. Look at how quickly Cena gets back to the ring after he shoves R-Truth back.
Remember, R-Truth was
Cena is ready.
In a feud for the WWE title.
Look at CM Punk. What's doing out here? CM Punk. CM Punk.
Just Raw Roulette.
This match. Ooh. And now Punk and Cena, the number one contender and the WWE champion, going at it.
You see how this man is wearing a Stone Cold 316 shirt? I believe Steve Austin put out a tweet where he was like, CM Punk melted his TV or something with the pipe. I'm going to put it up in post edit, but it's poetic justice, because Stone Cold was a rebel in the WWF Attitude Era, and now CM Punk at this time was coming into his own, or he was on his way out the door, and they just say, you know what, just show us what you got, kid. Such good sh**. No, I'm just playing. Truth won.
Punk is caught Cena.
That's my big homie. Oh, this was around the time where he had no music.
Thanks to CM Punk.
So, Tommaso Ciampa stole his whole gimmick.
No disqualification in this type of matchup. R-Truth took advantage.
And I hope he's just leaving, but I'm afraid we're going to hear more from Punk.
No kidding, Jerry. Crisscross applesauce. If you don't get that reference, you see young from the board.
John Cena, while you lay there, hopefully as uncomfortable as you possibly can be, I want you to listen to me. I want you to digest this, because before I leave in 3 weeks with your WWE Championship, I have a lot of things I want to get off my chest.
Let him know, homie.
I don't hate you, John. I don't even dislike you. I do like you. I like you a hell of a lot more than I like most people in the back.
That's the truth.
I hate this idea that you're the best. Because you're not. I'm the best. I'm the best in the world. There's one thing you're better at than I am, and that's kissing Vince McMahon's ass.
That's for sure.
You're as good as kissing Vince's ass as Hulk Hogan was. Oh. I don't know if you're as good as Dwayne, though. He's a pretty good ass kisser.
Who's this Dwayne fellow?
Always was and still is. Oops, I'm breaking the fourth wall. I am the best wrestler in the world.
This is around the time that they just started saying wrestler, too. But they hated that.
I've been the best ever since day one when I walked into this company, and I've been vilified and hated since that day because Paul Heyman saw something in me that nobody else wanted to admit. That's right, I'm a Paul Heyman guy. You know who else was a Paul Heyman guy? Brock Lesnar. And he split just like I'm splitting, but the biggest difference between me and Brock is I'm going to leave with the WWE Championship.
It's funny how both of them came to the company like less than a year later.
I've grabbed so many of Vincent K. McMahon's imaginary brass rings that it's finally dawned on me that they're just that. They're completely imaginary. The only thing that's real is me and the fact that day in and day out for almost 6 years, I have proved to everybody in the world that I am the best on this microphone, in that ring, even at commentary. Nobody can touch me.
That's for true.
And yet, no matter how many times I prove it, I'm not on your lovely little collector cups. I'm not on the cover of the program. I'm barely promoted. I don't get to be in movies. I'm certainly not on any crappy show on the USA Network. I'm not on the poster of WrestleMania. I'm not in the signature that's produced at the start of the show. I'm not on Conan O'Brien, I'm not on Jimmy Fallon, but the fact of the matter is I should be, and trust me, this isn't sour grapes, but the fact that Dwayne is in the main event of WrestleMania next year and I'm not makes me sick.
I remember watching this live, I didn't know what to think about this. Like, I'm not saying much because it's still...
Oh, hey, let me get something straight. Those of you who are cheering me right now, you are just the biggest part of me leaving as anything else. Because you're the ones that are sipping out of those collector cups right now.
Definitely.
You're the ones that buy those programs that my face isn't on the cover of. And then at 5 in the morning at the airport, you try to shove it in my face so you can get an autograph and try to sell it on eBay because you're too lazy to go get a real job.
That is definitely wrestling Twitter now. Like, if he wasn't talking about them then, because around 2011, wrestling Twitter wasn't really a thing. Like, it was, Twitter was still kind of sort of college only type of platform. Like, you didn't really see that many people. Around this time is when I actually joined Twitter. So Twitter wasn't really a thing until maybe 2012, 2013, when WWE and started really heavily promoting stuff on Twitter. And remember Tout? Yeah, it's like a lot reminiscing this type of stuff is bringing back memories, but my bad. I don't mean to keep pausing it. Let's continue. He was definitely talking about the IWC right here before it became an IWC.
I'm leaving with the WWE Championship on July 17th. And hell, who knows? Maybe I'll go defend it in New Japan Pro Wrestling. Maybe I'll go back to Ring of Honor.
That would have been cool. Of course, that didn't happen.
Hey, Colt Cabana, how you doing?
I didn't know that.
The reason I'm leaving is you people, because after I'm gone, you're still going to pour money into this company. I'm just a spoke on the wheel. The wheel's going to keep turning, and I understand that. But Vince McMahon's going to make money despite himself. He's a millionaire who should be a billionaire. You know why he's not a billionaire? It's because he surrounds himself with glad-handing, nonsensical
yes-men.
Like John Laurinaitis, who's going to tell him everything that he wants to hear.
I can say douchebag.
And I'd like to think that maybe this company will be better after Vince McMahon's dead. But the fact is, it's going to get taken over by his idiotic daughter and his doofus son-in-law and the rest of his stupid family. Let me tell
That's
you a personal truth. Story about Vince McMahon, all right? Can we do this whole bully camp?
I genuinely want to know what his story was. I really want to know. I still want to know to this day. Man. That was quite the summer. I remember watching, and then they fumbled the bag when they involved Kevin Nash and Triple H, and it got hella confusing for no reason. But oh, 10 years. It's been 10 years since that pipe bomb. Like, a lot, like I understand a lot of people are tired of seeing it or talking about it. I get it. I honestly get it. But you got to understand that promo alone got a lot of people hyped into wrestling again. Because around that time, you didn't really see that stuff. I mean, you had TNA in 2010 to 2011, but they dropped the ball real quick in 2010. We all remember what 2010 TNA was about. And then you had, obviously, you had Ring of Honors and the New Japans and all that stuff. But nothing really grabbed your attention until he cut that promo as far as WWE is concerned. And it kept us interested. And then when he left, they somewhat fumbled the bag again. But then they did the whole Daniel Bryan stuff. And then they had Brock Lesnar as the champion in 2015, which is by far one of my favorite title reigns at that time. And then it got heavy with the Roman Reigns getting shoved down our throat. And then we got what we got now with the pandemic and Roman basically being the top heel in all of wrestling right now. You can disagree with me, whatever you can, but that's just my opinion. Whatever. That was the pipe bomb. Let me know what you guys thought about the pipe bomb. Does it still hold merit to this day? Do you think he was basically being prophetic? Because a lot of stuff he was saying is still kind of happening today, especially with the whole you're cheering him and then you're going to still stoke the wheel and you're going to put money into this company and all that stuff. It still happened to this day. Let's just be real. But that was quite the reminiscent and the trip down memory lane. Like I said, if you're new to this channel, make sure you smash that like button. We're on the road to 200, what are we, 2,000 subscribers? We're on the road to 3,000 subscribers, so hopefully we can get to that, reach that number in the short period of time, whatever the case may be. Let's get the 3K. Make sure you hit that notification bell so you cannot miss any updates on this particular channel. This is mainly a Universal Heavy channel, but we're going to get right back into the being the Gresh side of things. And if you are having a good time, make sure you stay safe out here in these COVID and pre-vaccinated streets. And remember to always eat, sleep, flex, and repeat. We out. Peace. If you made it to this point in the video, I would like to shout out my Patreon backers. Without you guys, I would not be where I am today. Thank you. I ain't giving no chance like this.